It is officially new phone season, that time of year when big tech companies roll out the latest devices that offer a host of new features that make you want to throw your old phone right in the trash. Things like better screens, multiple cameras that look like spider eyeballs, and support for Wi-Fi 6. What is Wi-Fi 6? What happened to the first five? Well, it turns out you've actually been using one of the previous iterations of Wi-Fi, which can trace its roots back to 1997. Back then, it wasn't called Wi-Fi 1, but the much catchier 802.11. The number code was designated by the Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers, or IEEE. Since then, there have been several updates to the 802.11 standard, and each one had a different letter tacked on the end, like A, B, G, and N. But unless you're a diehard technophile, the letters and what they mean are hard to sort out. So to make things a bit easier for consumers, the next standard, 802.11ax, will be referred to as Wi-Fi 6, and previous standards will be retroactively renamed, like the last gen 802.11ac is now also called Wi-Fi 5. So, how is Wi-Fi 6 better? Well, like you might expect, it's promising faster speeds. Industry experts predict about 30% gains over Wi-Fi 5, with theoretical maximum download speeds up to 10 gigabits per second in ideal conditions. If you're into streaming 4K movies or want to jump into cloud gaming, those numbers will make you drool. One way it achieves this is by upping the number of bits the router can push out with each transmission. Sending information over the air is done by modulating radio waves. The way the wave is affected is interpreted by the device as a 1 or a 0, a process called quadrature amplitude modulation, or QAM. A 2-QAM router can affect radio waves in 2 distinct waves, so each transmission could only serve as a single 1 or a 0. A 4-QAM router can send 2 digits at a time. Wi-Fi 5 routers are 256 QAM, meaning they can send 8 bits with each transmission, while a Wi-Fi 6 device is 1024 QAM, adding another 2 binary digits to each transmission for a total of 10. That all sounds great, but keep in mind your Wi-Fi 6 router can only be as fast as your internet service provider will allow. So depending on how you're wired into the grid and what kind of plan you pay for, your mileage may vary. Aside from the bump in speed limit, the exciting thing about Wi-Fi 6 is how it delivers internet to multiple devices. The first improvement is the router's ability to split up the channels it's communicating over, allowing different devices to get service directly, simultaneously, and cutting down on latency. Wi-Fi 6 routers are also able to use the spatial differences between devices to tailor the information it sends and receives. And if there are multiple smart devices like thermostats and refrigerators that regularly ping your router, a Wi-Fi 6 router will put them on a schedule to ease congestion. What this all means is Wi-Fi 6 is great news for situations that deal with a lot of devices all at once. Stadiums and airports are ideal places for the new routers, and those with Wi-Fi 6 compatible phones, tablets, and computers will reap the benefits. Otherwise, unless you've got a home festooned with smart tech or pay your ISP for the very best internet speeds possible, you're just fine with your old phone and router that are still using the old 802.11ac. Excuse me, Wi-Fi 5. While Wi-Fi 6 certification just officially launched, the development of Wi-Fi 7 is already underway. Have we ever mentioned how fast tech moves? Wireless internet has been around for 2 decades, so when is wireless charging going to be a thing? Check out Amanda's video on that here. Is Wi-Fi 6 enough to make you upgrade your phone? Let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time on Seeker.